This is where you get the stories and also the opinion, and the opinion of these gentlemen who will tell us where they would like to see Pollard to bat on a regular basis. Which number?
Oh, I think they've got it spot on at the minute. You know, I think they try and use him in that back end.
Yeah.
You know, they clearly feel that the last six or seven overs, they realise how destructive it is. The players at the top of the order, the Cox and Rohit Sharma's, they've got some high-class players at the top of the order. And when you've got, you look at, you know, the likes of Rajasthan, you look at RCB, teams that are struggling, they don't have that Dre Russ, Kieron Pollard in the middle that you just... I don't think you can rely on them to be so consistent like they have been. You know, they've been a little bit over-reliant on that style of player. But, you know, every T20 team in the world would love that style of cricketer, five, six or seven, depending on when you throw them in there.
Yeah, and they've got a Hardik as well.
Just hit sixes.
Yeah.
You know, they're there to just call. And if they get two dot balls, they're not bothered because they know they can just hit three or four sixes in the space of the next four or five balls, which just completely changes the game.
Yeah, there's something about him, Joy, because last season he looked like, I don't know, it looked like he had checked out. Like he was not really in that rhythm, you could not tell. And this year again, and with Pollard, you can't tell because you can't tell by his body language when he walks
or his expression.
Yeah, you don't know whether he's asleep or whether he's going to put the bowlers to sleep. You have no idea what he's going to do. Like the range of emotions, you just can't tell. And the last innings, again, was just insanity.
Absolutely spectacular. And the consistency, exactly what he said, that you expect guys to do that, you know, half the time. But to do that 75-80% of the time as they're doing it, it's an amazing record. And I mean, the last match, I think that's the highest Pollard has got for them. It's just been, I think he's crossed something. And the beauty about these guys is they've, you know, when you come to T20 cricket, you don't have batting orders. You have batting over orders.
Yeah.
So if it's a 12th over, it's so-and-so. It's a 14th over, it's so-and-so. So it's not going by where you are in the batting order, but what over it is. So if it's the 14th over and you lose your second wicket, Pollard could walk in then. But it's only the over number that they're calling it, that okay, this many number of balls he has. So that's interesting. Both Russell and Pollard, they use like that.
And sometimes, you know, with older players, senior players, you know, you go through a little bit of a journey in your career. You start fresh and young and you want to play every game, and then you do really well. It almost becomes that you've played too much and it becomes a little bit of a drain, travel, being away, and you're like, oh, I don't really want to do this. And then you get to the last few years of your career and you realise you've got to maximise playing. Because it's the greatest time of your life. And it takes that period of just being in the middle of your career, coming towards the back end, when you start going, oh, playing again, getting up, getting out of bed. And then it clicks in your mind, and you go, wait a minute, I've got a few years left, I better enjoy this.
Yeah.
And then because of all the knowledge you've had from playing all those years, you can just maximise it. And you look at Pollard, you look at Dre Russ, Chris Gayle, the knowledge that they've got in their minds, and all that was lacking two or three years ago, from them not being consistent, it's just, they probably just couldn't be bothered all the time. I know that sounds, they just, and you go, oh, it's
no, great. We can all get demotivated.
Correct,
at times,
and
right?
I just think they know that they're coming towards it, and that's why I would pick every single one of them for the World Cup for the West Indies.
Ooh, interesting.
I would, because why would you not want to use that amount of knowledge and skill and power? And you ask all the bowlers in the 50-over game, which of the West Indies they'd like to see in the team? And they say the ones that played last year. Would you want to see the Pollards, the Dre Russes? Would you want Narayan in the team? Would you like Azura Jolly, Chris? They go, oh, no thanks, no thanks. Don't have them in the squad. You know, just make sure that you put them onto the side, because you know, no bowlers in the world are going to want to bowl. Yeah, 50-over cricket would be more daunting on the body for them. It'd be harder, but you know, if their minds are telling them that they're really enjoying cricket and they want to get out there and represent the West Indies at the World Cup. And it'll be their minds, you know, their body, over 15 players in the squad. They're not going to be able to play every game. But I would have every single one of them. And Jason Holder is the style of leader. He's a magnificent captain.
Yeah.
And he's the kind of leader that'll go, get them. I'll manage them.
Yeah.
And he's managed, you know, the likes of Chris Gayle coming back in. He played against the England side and did fantastic.
Man of the series.
He was outstanding. And Holder is the type who'll just want his best. He can galvanise a team.
Yeah,
he's got that leadership now. He can galvanise team. He'll be saying, just get me the best players. I want every single best player in my squad, because if I get them all there and I rotate them nicely, I said they're going to be a massive threat in the World Cup.